Video I will describe hunting working terriers, and I will especially begin with herd working terriers. I will discuss working types of Lakeland working border terrier, the white fell terrier, for example the Russells, but also the Bull Russells that you see lately. I will discuss the black fell terrier, especially the Patterdale terrier, also the dog on the leash, and I will discuss other types of working terriers that are more jack of all trades, for example the German Hund Terrier, also known as the German Yacht Terrier, and also a specialistic terrier for above the ground work, being the Heide Terrier, which is a specialist type of terrier for hog work. As an alternative to the German Hunting Terrier, I will also talk about the Westfalen Terrier, which is a little bit more laid back type of terrier as compared to the German Hunt Terrier that is upcoming. Hope you like this video. Those breeds will be talked about in successive order, and please enjoy. Bye bye. So another candidate would be the working Lakeland Terrier. The working Lakeland Terrier is a breed very close to the Lakeland Terrier that is a show version, but with less exaggerated features, less fox terrier influences, and looks a lot more like a long-haired Patterdale terrier. The dog on the leash here is a black fell terrier, smooth-coated, also known as Patterdale terrier. Oi, oi. Oh. Working Lakelands are known to be hard workers, good coat at the deck stem, very good for earthwork, will confront the quarry, are not excessive barkers, quite silent, strong type of working dogs. At the current state, they are far less common than they once were, and I think a lot of the working Lakelands have been either assimilated or switched or taken over, in this case by the Patterdale Terrier, which has similar properties, but also is worked and evolved more and comes in different coats depending on the terrain. Working Border Terriers are often very close in resemblance to the show versions. I think the Border Terrier has not changed that much, being a show dog now. Some are still being worked, but this type of terrier has a broken coat, a very short, strong skull, but lately, especially show versions, they have been bred to look bigger than they shoot as a traditional working dog. That made a big skull, but also a bigger chest that was not able to go into the narrow fox tent anymore. The same problem that Lakeland has, that the Border Terrier is now less known as being a hunting dog. Only a few enthusiasts still keep them, and most of their work is now being done by Patterdale Terriers. This is Estacado, my smooth-coated Patterdale Terrier on the leash, and also the Patterdale Terrier comes in a broken coat variety, like the Border Terrier, next to smooth. As you see here, this Patterdale Terrier and the long hair that looks more like a black lake. But so these terriers are all similar in attributes and have their own merits. The good thing is that a lot of Border Terriers are still being used if they are worked. So for example, crossbred to Patterdale Terriers, and also some Patterdale Terrier blood finds its way into Border Terrier lines, and this is a good thing. Often a Border Terrier brings a very strong head, which is a confrontational type of terrier. Also they are very courageous, strong and silent. So this is like a miniature catch dog, very good for earthwork if you have a good working one. Next to the Black Fell Terrier, example that you see here as being a Patterdale Terrier, there's also a White Fell Terrier. White Fell Terriers have similar attributes, are also being used to catch foxes, but are a little bit less confrontational and more of a baying type of feral terrier. So they go and confront the foxes and badgers if needed, and but they also physically, but they stay out of harm's way a little bit more, and that way they can be kept for multiple hunts instead of recuperation after some hard hunts where they have been damaged themselves as well against fox, but especially badger. This white feral terrier has a more of a baying type of style, so it will bay, bark at its prey, also attack it and then jump back again, so more taunting. Only when it can have a very good grip, it will go all in. These dogs are still courageous, but are a little bit less devastating to themselves because they don't seek that confrontational style. They try to keep out of harm's way if possible, but still go in. Examples of white feral terriers are the Jack Russell and also Parson Russell that are now sometimes still being hunted, especially Parson Russells are. And the new phenomenon is the Blue Russell, which is a cross between a working fell, so for example a Parson Russell, and also some added blood of bull terrier lines, especially miniature bull terrier, because they want to keep the size a little bit down. Sometimes the bull terrier is watered down to 12.5 or 25%, but very often you also see it 25% to keep the properties of the bull. The reason for this cross is that they want to get more courage and more power and holding capabilities of the bull terrier, combined with still the baying, taunting type of white feral terrier, so that you have a dog that you can work almost every day of the week, even on hard quarry, because it won't be totally destroyed by its opponent and don't take too much damage, because it is not that out and out confrontational as, for example, a Pretterdale terrier, such a dog that you see here on the leash often is. Then, in many people's view, the elite Ur terrier, the black feral terrier. Black feral terriers come in different shapes and sizes, also different coats. So long haired, rough coated, and also smooth coated like this one. And the prime example of the black feral terrier is the Pretterdale terrier. Contrary to its name, not all Pretterdale terriers are black. Most are, however, because black is also quite a dominant color. Benefit of a black dog is that they can release the heat when they are below ground, very efficient because of that color, and they don't have a lot to suffer from the heat outside in the field because they are developed to work underground. Very good dog on badger, foxes. Also this type of dog is very good at confronting it. It's a silent type of dog. Despite the size, they are classified as strong dogs. The drawback is that they are that confrontational that they often suffer a lot of damage, and once they are damaged they need some time to heal up again, whereas a less confrontational style dog, for example white feral terrier or bull russell especially, could be hunted more days, in theory at least. The benefit of a catch dog type of terrier is that the quarry has a hard time to escape. Also they will stay till dark. They are very strong type of dogs and also very very good workers. The future of the Pretterdale terrier is that it is a still evolving breed. Not that it is not good enough, but they, like many working breeds, they keep looking to improve upon it, and also there are mixed versions sometimes, because for example one hunter likes a dog that's very confrontational, very hard, another likes a dog that has a little bit more baying into it, so more of a mixed type Pretterdale. Crosses are that are often seen are crosses with border terrier working Lakeland, sometimes a little bit of bull and terrier breeds are if used, especially Staffordshire Bull Terrier, working lines, or American Pit Bull Terrier. But most of the characteristics are already set into the Patterdog Terrier as is. Nee, nee. Hoi, hoi.
Hoi, hoi.
Go back. We're fighting. So, that being said, Patterdog Terrier has a lot of terrier influence compared to Staffordshire Bull Terrier or American Pit Bull Terrier, and a lot of bull influences as compared to, for example, yeah, a Lakeland or a Whitefell Terrier, but still not as much as a bull has, as for example, a Border Terrier has. So we discussed some terriers really bred for earthwork, and now we also discuss the Yacht Terrier, the German Yacht Terrier, or German Hunting Terrier, which is a breed developed as a jack of all trades. But this is a dog that can be used on badger and foxes as a more of a baying, aggressive type of fowl, instead of just all out like a Patterdog Terrier. All out confrontational, these dogs are a way to keep out of harm's way if possible. On the other hand, they are extremely courageous, and they're also very persistent. These types of dogs have great stamina, quite a good nose, especially for a terrier. They're also used above ground, especially on a black quarry. So, for example, wild hogs, and can chase them. They are quite quarrelsome. They will fight among each other a lot more than, for example, Patterdog Terriers in general. And they come in three coats as well. So the long haired rough coat that was originally bred, and also now you have a smooth coated Yacht Terrier and a broken coated sometimes. But often you see the long haired and sometimes the smooth coated, not many times the intermediate broken coated types. The German Hunting Terrier is a dog that can do everything, but it's not a dog that excels at everything. However, it is a breed that has been very well selected out of a good specimen, and they developed it as a breed that is a very good hunting terrier, perhaps the best, because it can do everything. However, there are some genetic problems into the breed, especially because of the inbreeding that was so that hard. And there were some troubles because they had such a limited gene pool after some decreases in the Yacht Terrier population by, for example, wars that were fought, and also other problems because they only selected the black and tan dogs to work with instead of the other colorations. This has led to different other breeds, which I will come back later, but most notably the Westfalen Terrier and a Heide Terrier, both also German breeds. So the Westfalen Terrier is like a more family orientated and a little bit healthier Yacht Terrier. That was the base, so you get a dog that is less aggressive, especially to its owner, less nervous as well, so it could be kept in house if needed. Yacht Terrier is very hard to keep in house because it's overly active constantly, and not a nice thing to have in many a house. The Westfalen Terrier is a little bit more laid back. They crossed in some Fox Terrier blood, especially to make it an easier type of dog, and has a more even temperament. The Westfalen Terrier is a breed that has many of the benefits of the Yacht Terrier with a little bit less of its drawbacks, and it's an upcoming breed. Also, because it is less quarrelsome among each other, it would be easier to use them in pack hunting, and could also, as such, have a bigger role in hawk hunting. That being said, still the German Yacht Terrier is often used a lot more than the Westfalen Terrier, which is upcoming terrier breed. Westfalen Terrier can also be used underground, like the German Hunting Terrier, has also similar size. Often German Hunting Terriers and Westfalen Terrier are a little bit on the bigger side for working underground, but it's more of a jack of all trade type of dog. So the Heide Terrier is like a specialistic type of German Jagd Terrier, so German Hunt Terrier. German Hunt Terrier is a jack of all trades, so both earthwork on fox and badger, as well as especially hunting on wild boar. Whereas the Heide Terrier is specifically developed for one purpose and one purpose only, and that's hunting wild boar. So less quarrelsome, bigger, stronger than a Jagd Terrier, and also a dog that is easy to be kept in a group and also easy to be kept in house. They bred in different terrier breeds. I saw at the beginning especially that they used a lot of Airedale blood, a little bit of Irish Terrier blood, to get a little bit of different temperament and also different size as compared to the normal German Hunting Terrier. And they also added bull blood. In the beginning I saw a lot of bull terrier blood being added. Okay, I say in the beginning because nowadays you see a different type of Heide Terrier coming into existence. More and more looking like a dog that has a lot of pit bull or American Staffordshire Terrier blood infused. So it's a dog that has a little bit of the resemblance of a miniature Dogo Argentino, albeit being half the size. And the coloration is also often black and tan, like German Hunting Terriers or Airedale Terriers. But they also come in the other colors, even completely black. So I mentioned the Dogo Argentino. This is a dog that is specifically developed for hawk work and a little bit of puma cougar hunting. It's a very big dog, a running mastiff, so to say. But as I mentioned, it's twice the size. So for example, if you have a Dogo Argentino which ranges about 40 kilograms as hunting weight, the Heide Terrier will weigh the half of it, so like 20 kilogram range for hunting. It's a very strong dog, as most terriers are. So also compared to Petterdale or a Jagd Terrier, twice the size of that, approximately. It's less quarrelsome, so especially compared to the Hunting Terrier. And I think that the route to take more of American Pit Bull Terrier or American Staffordshire Terrier blood into this consideration is a good one, because Airedale Terriers are no real terriers. They have a lot of hound blood, especially Alp Otter hound blood. They only appear as a terrier to me. They were never bred for terrier work, so work on the ground. And the strength of an American Pit Bull Terrier or even a Bull Terrier or American Staffordshire Terrier is a lot bigger compared to the kilograms they bring. And also in other countries these type of dogs are used as a hawk hunting dog. So American Pit Bull Terriers, American Staffordshire Terriers and also American Bulldogs are used for this purpose instead of Airedale Terriers normally. There might be some Airedale Terriers that function, but most that have seen Airedale Terriers have found out that they are quite, how to say this, less courageous than your average type of terrier, and it's more of a hound type of dog, so only bark at it instead of gripping it, whereas the Heide Terriers you also grip and hold. So I think it's a very wise decision, and also the German Hunt Terrier already brings a good nose and also a hunting sense, and also the other terrier breeds could add, in my opinion. Also the Petterdale Terrier, the dog I have here on the leash, could have a good role in developing a future Heide Terrier. If they bring in too big a type of dog, for example American Bulldog or Dogo Argentino blood would be infused into a Heide Terrier, then you could bring back the size a little bit with a Petterdale Terrier. Petterdale Terrier is also a lot more relaxed type of dog as compared to the German Hunt Terrier. Also has a good hunting sense, good coat. You have different coat options as well. If you want some more protection, rougher coat, for example, or you want an easier coat, you could go with smooth coat. But we will see how the future will direct itself. Also, the Bull Terrier blood. Bull Terrier is not an elite canine warrior normally lately, but has found its way also as a hawk hunting dog. The benefit is that Bull Terriers are often less confrontational against other dogs, but still I know many of cases that Bull Terrier blood can be very confrontational as well, and also a benefit, the Bull Terrier seems to click quite well with many breeds, so this is a good thing as well. I can also imagine that in the future in Highland Terrier blood, perhaps a little bit of lurcher blood will be infused. For example, the Bull lurchers, crosses between pit bull and a greyhound, for example, would have a way to find themselves into Highland Terrier blood. And then the size can again be brought back by infusing, for example, some Pachyderm Terrier blood as well, or German Hunting Terrier, which is also a smaller breed. Well, that was it. Hope you liked this video. If you do, please subscribe and let me know in the comments.